Hello children, in this video I am going to discuss about library classes, the second chapter of your book Understanding Computer Applications, published by Arya Publishing Company. This chapter begins with the discussion of JCL. JCL stands for Java Class Library. It is the major component of JDK. JDK is the Java compiler and it stands for Java Development Kit. JCL contains various library packages and each library package contains a number of similar types of library classes. Each library class contains some functions which can be used in our source programs to perform various calculations. For example, the java.io package contains classes which support input-output operations in our programs. Now the question is how to use the functions of these library classes. To use the functions of these library classes, the corresponding library classes have to be imported to our source program. Now to import a particular library class into our source program, we have to use the import statement, and with that import statement we have to specify the name of the class that we need to import. For example, suppose we want to use the functions of scanner class in our program. In that case, we have to import the scanner class. We have to write the import statement as import java.util.scanner. Now, this statement imports the scanner class of java.util package and it allows us to use the functions of scanner class in our source program. Now to end up this point, you need to remember that java.lng is the package that contains all the fundamental classes of Java which are needed by every Java program. So this is the package which is imported to every Java program automatically. Now the second point in the chapter is the discussion on primitive data type and composite data type. Primitive data types are the basic data types, the fundamental data types which are created by the language developers. These data types are used to declare variables, to create variables which can store a single data value, maybe a number or a character. For example, a variable of int type can store an integer value. But these primitive data types are not sufficient to handle the operations in most of the situations. And in those situations, we need to create new data types by combining these primitive data types. That is why those new data types are called composite data types. Now in Java, to create new data types, we have to define classes. Using a class, we can combine some primitive data types to make a new data type. Since class is created by user, it is called a user-defined data type, and because the class contains many primitive data types into a single data type, it is called a composite data type. Now to sum up, primitive data type and composite data type, let me discuss the difference between these two data types. The first difference is that a primitive data type is a fundamental data type, but a composite data type is a combination of some primitive data types. That is why a primitive data type cannot be broken down into parts. It is the atomic element. But a composite data type can be divided into a number of parts. The second difference is that primitive data types are created by the language developers, but composite data types are created by the users, the programmers. Now we will move on to the next part, that is the discussion on wrapper classes. In this part, we will discuss two things. The first thing is what a wrapper class is, and the second thing is what are wrapper classes used for. Now, what a wrapper class is? A wrapper class is a class in java.lang package that contains a primitive data value in terms of an object. It has functions to manipulate the values of a primitive data type. For example, the wrapper class integer contains the primitive data type int, and it has functions to manipulate the values of int type. Now, to discuss the use of wrapper classes, we can say that a wrapper class is used to store primitive values in terms of objects. And the second use of the wrapper class is to convert a string data into primitive data types and vice versa. Since there are 8 primitive data types in Java, such as byte, sort, int, long, float, double, char, and boolean. There are 8 primitive data types in Java. And that is why there are 8 wrapper classes corresponding to each of the 8 primitive data types. For example, character is the wrapper class for the data type char. Integer is the wrapper class for the data type int. Float is the wrapper class for the data type float. The list is given in the book. To end up the discussion on wrapper classes, you have to remember the point that a primitive data type is written in small letters, but its corresponding wrapper class is written with the first letter capital. For example, the data type float is written in small letters, but its corresponding wrapper class float is written with F capital. Now we will move to the next point, where we will discuss the methods of wrapper classes which can convert string values to primitive data types. Wrapper classes have methods such as parse and valueOf to convert string values to primitive data types. To convert a string value to a primitive data type, the parse function or the value of function of its corresponding wrapper class is to be used. For example, consider the following code. The first statement in the code declares n to be a variable of int type and s to be a variable of string type to store the value 25 in string format. The second statement of the code uses the parseInt function of integer class to convert s from string format to int format and store in the variable n. And the third statement uses the value of function of the integer wrapper class to convert the value of s from string format to int format and store in the variable n. In the same way, we can convert a string value to other primitive data types such as long, float, double by using the corresponding parse function or value of function. Now to end off this point, this discussion, you need to remember that a string value which contains only digits can be converted to a primitive data type. The second point is the value of function is available in JDK 1.5 or higher version. Now to end up the discussion in this video, I will tell you about the function which can convert a value of a primitive data type to string format. To convert a value of a primitive data type to string format, the corresponding toString function of the wrapper class has to be used. For example, the statement string s equals to integer dot toString 25 is the int type value which is converted to string format by toString function of integer wrapper class and is stored in the variable s. In the same way, we can convert the values of other primitive data types to string format by using the toString function of their corresponding wrapper classes.